Hey guys, thank you for coming and tuning in to the Lopez Family Fertility Journey. I'm Katie's husband. My name is Al. A little bit about our history. We started talking back in 2007 on MySpace. May that year. We became an official couple, and from there, as they say, the rest was history. 2016, May, we decided to get married, where we live in the town hall. It rained that day, but they always told us that if it rains on your wedding, that means it's a good luck. Went to Hawaii for a honeymoon. And decided that that year we're gonna start trying. We started in, I guess, November, and didn't get pregnant until the following year. And a little bit about my feelings towards being a dad. I've had that as my biggest goal since I was 14. Besides being a dad, I always had two other goals around that time, which was to be somebody in life and to be a husband to somebody who was gonna love me. And I did three of those goals in my short time. We got pregnant in February after my birthday, same month, and I was told in March. The way that she announced it to me, we were at a friend's house, and she went to the bathroom a couple times. I just thought, too much water or soda that day for her. She really had to go. But that same afternoon, she told me that she wanted to go to the mall and look for scrubs because she was a nurse. So, we went, she drove. Usually I'm the one who drives, but I was okay that day for her to drive. And we spent about probably 10 minutes looking for a parking spot, which there was tons available, but she was very adamant on this particular spot. Well, after about 10 minutes of not finding the spot, she parked and she reached over and showed me her pregnancy strips. And at first, it didn't hit me that she was pregnant. And all I could do was cry and say, "Is this for real?" And once it hit me, besides crying, all I could do was say thank you to her and hug her as tight as I could. So we went to the mall after the parking, and in there she told me that she wanted to find the spot where it usually says, mothers to be or mothers expecting, and I told her that it was okay, that they actually had it across the street at the other parking spot. It's a kind of strip mall where Baby R Us is, and we told family friends afterwards. Mostly our immediate family knew ahead. We grabbed a pacifier, did a little note in a note card and put it in a box and let them open it at Logan's, and got congratulated. My mom cried, her family cried, and from there we told our friends on a Facebook Live, and a couple of them we sent a picture of both of us holding a Prego, kind of like tomato sauce, pasta sauce. And people congratulated us and whatnot. About early April is when things started turning for the worst for us. I was actually working that night shift at in an EMS station, and at 6 in the morning, as I was about to get off an hour, I got a phone call from Katie. And knowing her, she usually never calls me unless it's an emergency while I'm at work. And I picked up the phone, and I could hear her on the other line, well, on the other end of the line, hysterical, frantic, scared, crying. And my stomach fell. I got off the phone with her after I, calmed her down a little bit, told her that I was coming home, and I bolted from work to get to her. Took her to the hospital that morning and was told by the doctor there that it was nothing that he saw out of the ordinary, and that if we go to the OBGYN, they'll do more tests and see. So there was a little hope there, and off we went. About mid-April 2017, that same year, same month, is when the OBGYN, not ours that we usually went to, but a different one, informed us that she had experienced a miscarriage. I was holding her hand, and I kind of had a out-of-body experience. I wasn't there per se as she was explaining, what happened. I know I saw Katie crying, just looking at her, and I could see myself above in the room looking down at where I was and her and the doctor. And when she asked if we had any questions, I asked her, can she repeat it again, because I couldn't quite hear it. And she told me, and it felt like a train hit me. And after that train hit me, it felt like bus hit me. And the feeling is, I can't describe it, but it was like the worst thing possible. We went home. We told our immediate family. Half of them came over and talked to us, apologized, hugged us, cried with us, kissed us, told us that they loved us. And I knew that day, after everybody left, that I told my wife that she didn't need to go back to work, and that I was going to be responsible for everything financially wise moving forward until she felt better. That day when I told her that, I knew in that moment that I needed to shut my feelings to the side, my emotions to the side, and just worry and focus on her. I cried when she fell asleep. I begged after about 15 minutes of nonstop crying, hysterical, into a pillow. Anybody who was listening to me, if they could actually switch places with me, I would have switched places with our angel baby. I pleaded that if they took me instead and gave Katie back, the baby, and let us go through the pregnancy without any complication, that I was okay to go. May came. She passed a miscarriage. Normally, didn't take a pill or anything. And from the beginning of the miscarriage, when they told us, it was just a downhill for us. That anniversary, we didn't celebrate. The due date, November, we cried. It was a horrible experience that year for us. Father's Day and Mother's Day was atrocious, a disaster. We're not happy at all. She was crying after the miscarriage, day in and day out. I had family and friends come and talk to her while I was at work, be with her. And in the morning, I would barely get any sleep, and I would be with her. I shut myself out at work, didn't talk to anybody. When we had a pediatric call, I always told my partner to take the call because I didn't want to, see a baby or deal with a baby just because of the miscarriage. I personally shut everybody out, friends. I was always jealous and angry when a friend of mine told me that they were pregnant and they were expecting. I just hated all that. Fast forward the following year, we didn't celebrate my birthday because I didn't want to. She wanted to. I just didn't feel it was right. That whole year, she was getting better. I can't even say 20%, but she was coming around, And I was shutting myself out from her and everybody even more than I was already. I think right around Christmas last year is when I've told her that I really, really needed to go to therapy. I'm in therapy now. I've been there, I want to say, 2 months now, maybe three. It's helping me out. I'm talking to my wife more openly about my feelings from the miscarriage to now. It's easier to communicate with her. It's actually doing great for me. Because I wouldn't be in here, the nursery, if it wasn't for therapy. Because this was the biggest obstacle for me outside of talking to my wife, was it being able to come in the room that brought so much joy to her, and me. Mostly her, because the women experience it more. But I remember her painting that mural back there. And watching her through the door and seeing how excited she was and happy, joyful, and glowing. And after that, I felt this was like a scary place. I felt like I couldn't come in here at all because I would break down and cry and just have bad feelings. But therapy has actually helped me to come in here. I've told my therapist about, being jealous and being so hateful to people who are close to us that have gotten pregnant. An example is like my sister. Like, I have had a resentment, hatred that she got pregnant, jealousy. But I'm doing better now. with it, and I've communicated with her, which is something I would never have done if it wasn't for therapy. And I'm glad that I did that. I'm glad that I'm going to therapy. Feelings now, I do have doubt. I do go sometimes down memory lane of the past 2 years now, since the miscarriage. And I have those horrific feelings, those memories at times. And I remember what my therapist said, and I get through it. Yes, it's okay, as she says, to have these feelings, as long as I talk to communicate with people and just let it be and just let it go. 'Cause she along, excuse me, like my wife says, we're gonna get pregnant again. It's gonna happen. And I have hope now. Father's Day, Mother's Day, due date, November 23rd, 2017. I don't like it. I don't like doing any of those. Our anniversary, I don't like celebrating because it's in that time frame of the miscarriage. Since April begins until April the next year is kind of like a bad time for me. Well, makes no sense, but it is bad. I don't like that. I don't like the April to June, sort of say, because that's the worst for me. Because you have the miscarriage anniversary, which happened right after the miscarriage. Mother's Day is in there, and I don't like that. It's hard to celebrate Mother's Day with her. Father's Day in June, I don't like it. I don't want to celebrate it. We are, parents to an angel baby, but I don't like it. July through November is okay at times, but there's times where I hate those months too. November is terrible because it's the due date. It's horrible. I don't like it. December is not that's not another good holiday season for me. Her birthday is okay because, it didn't happen. There was nothing bad, but it's still at times hard. But you begin February and March are another day months that I don't like. But I'm coming to terms that, it happened and I need to move on. Not forget, but move on. I know another thing I came to terms with this year going through therapy is that real men do cry and show emotions. A lot of the male population doesn't agree with that, but she says it's okay, and my wife says it's okay, and I've come to the realization that it is okay for a guy to cry. I'm open to Katie about feelings. And it wouldn't happen if it wasn't for therapy. And the only reason I say that is because where we live, it's hard to get to know a guy that's gone through a miscarriage or is going through a miscarriage and to be able to talk to them, because here everybody is set in their, masculine way of men don't cry, men don't talk about the feelings of the miscarriage. And I wish it was different. I wish there was more of an open male group here to put myself on and talk to them. You know, I wish there was a support group of males here, but there isn't. My friends, I have maybe one friend of my wife's whose husband's been through a miscarriage, but he doesn't like talking about it. So it is hard to find that male friend who I could talk to about. So therapy is best for me. But I want the male side to know that it's okay to cry. It's okay to talk to each other. We are out there. It is common now for a couple to go through miscarriage, and it's okay for a male to show their feelings and express their feelings and talk about it. We shouldn't shut ourselves out and think like, you know, we're less of a man if we talk about it. Talk to your significant other if you can. Support each other. I tried Facebook groups, and a lot of them are not literally not even a state away, so I can't even do that and try to, you know, plan a little weekend, you know, retreat and see if we could talk because they live so far away and it's hard. Also, I want the guys to know that it's okay to tell other people that you should care about our feelings too. You know, we do cry, we do have emotions, not to the extent as our wives, because you know they carried the baby, but we do have feelings. Please, you know, to our friends, you know, reach out to us. You know, we do cry, we do hurt, you know. I know we'll get pregnant again, but there's times where it's hard to stay positive. Sometimes listening to my wife and her, when she's reading in her women's group, she says, you know, some women go through like two, three, four, five, and so on, so many miscarriages. Some who really can't get pregnant at all, and it scares me. But you know, us relying on each other should give us hope that we will get pregnant. And if we don't, it's okay. We're not less of a human being for that. Nobody is. To the couples who can't get pregnant, I'm so sorry. And I sent my love out to you guys because I know how hard it is for you guys and how much you want to be pregnant. To the people who are going to experience their rainbow baby, congratulations. You know, hopefully it goes smoothly this time and you get to see your rainbow. To the ones who are thinking about trying, good luck. You know, as my wife's group says, you know, I think it's a baby dust or something like that, you know, that I hope you get pregnant. I hope, you know, you get to experience, you know, fatherhood and motherhood. And to the ones who are beginning to go through the miscarriage phase and you know, the beginning of, you know, already crying and not knowing, you know, if you could talk to anybody, just reach out and good luck. It's hard to reach out for help. I know this is my first video, and I'm kind of nervous, as you can tell. I don't know what to say. but I kind of wanted to do this through the male, you know, perspective, through the male's eye, what we go through. Hopefully I'll make more of these with my wife or by myself. And you know, please stay with us in this journey. Much love to everybody out there. Magic dust to you guys. Hopefully you get to get pregnant and experience it. Can't wait to see your videos and your journey. To the rainbow baby that waits for us. I cannot wait to meet you. And to our angel baby, I will see you in the next life. Not like I used to think before, which was soon, because I thought about that. I thought about suicide because of how embarrassed I was. But not no more. I will see you soon when it's my time. But I guess that's it for me. Sorry if it was short. Sorry if it was all over. I just don't do these at all, videos. And peace and love to you guys.